A very good morning, dear students. In last class, we have seen about the classification and nomenclature of aldehydes and ketones. Now, we'll see about the preparations of aldehydes and ketones. So, first we'll see common preparations of both aldehydes and ketones. So, by using three important methods, we can prepare both aldehydes and ketones. The first one is by oxidation of alcohols. Okay, whenever alcohols undergo oxidation, they can be converted into aldehydes and ketones. If primary alcohols undergo oxidation, they can give aldehyde. If secondary alcohol undergo oxidation, they can give ketones. Okay, so second method is by dehydrogenation of alcohols. So dehydrogenation means removal of hydrogen. Okay, whenever the primary alcohol vapors are passed through silver or copper metal, so they loses hydrogen, converts into aldehyde. So by undergoing dehydrogenation, they can be converted into aldehydes. If we pass the vapors of secondary alcohols through silver or copper tube, again they loses hydrogen, converts into ketones. That means dehydrogenation of primary and secondary alcohols can be converted into aldehydes and ketones. Clear? Now the third one, that is from hydrocarbons. Even hydrocarbons can be converted into corresponding alcohols. So example, the first method is ozonolysis of alkene. About this ozonolysis, we have studied in the first year. Okay, when alkene undergo ozonolysis followed by reaction with zinc and water, it can be converted into aldehyde or ketone or both. Sometimes a mixture of aldehyde and ketone can also be obtained. So is alkene example of hydrocarbon? Exactly. When alkene undergo ozonolysis followed by reaction with zinc and water, it can give aldehyde or ketone or both. Okay. Next, another method is by hydration of alkynes. Example of alkyne is ethyne. Hydration means addition of water. When you add water to this ethyne in presence of sulfuric acid and mercuric sulfate, it can be converted into acetaldehyde. So what is acetaldehyde? CH3CHO. Is it containing aldehyde group? Yes. That means by using these methods, these three important methods, we can prepare both aldehydes and ketones. Understand? Now we'll see the methods which we use to give only aldehydes. Now, preparations of only aldehydes. By using few important methods, we can only prepare aldehydes. In that, the first one is from azyl chloride or acid chlorides. And this method is also known as Rosenmann reaction. So, in azyl chloride, when azyl chloride undergo hydrogenation in presence of palladium and barium sulfide, it can be converted into aldehyde. So I am taking here one of the aromatic azyl chloride. Okay, C double bond O Cl, aromatic acid chloride. When it undergo hydrogenation in presence of palladium and barium sulfate. Okay, so exactly here bond involves in breakage. Two hydrogens are there, right? One hydrogen is taken by Cl, eliminates as HCl. Another hydrogen is added to C double bond O group. Then we will get here C double bond O. Now to this hydrogen is added. Is it aldehyde? Exactly. Benzaldehyde. Okay, benzaldehyde is obtained. When azyl chloride undergo hydrogenation in presence of palladium and barium sulfate, they can be converted into aldehydes. And this method is known as Rosenmann reaction. Very, very important for 2 marks for board exam. Now see the second method of preparation of aldehyde. That is from nitriles and esters. And this reaction is known as Stefan reaction. Okay. When nitriles undergo reaction with stannous chloride and HCl, first it converts into an intermediate, that is imine, which again on hydrolysis converts into aldehydes. So I am taking here nitrile. Cyanides are nothing but nitriles. RCN. When it reacts with HCl and SnCl2, stannous chloride. Okay, reduction will take place. So exactly between carbon and nitrogen, we can also write this as C triple bond N. So this pi bond involves in breakage. So this is acting as one of the reducing agent. That means it adds hydrogen. One hydrogen added to carbon, one hydrogen added to nitrogen. converts into R CH double bond. Triple bond is converted into double bond NH. So this is nothing but imine. Okay. Now this imine undergo hydrolysis, addition of water. So exactly bond breaks here. Okay. Oxygen of water is added here. Two hydrogens of water added to NH. Converts to RCHO. Now NH is added by two hydrogens, converts into NH3 ammonia. Okay, this is the method to prepare aldehyde. When nitriles undergo reduction in presence of HCl and SnCl2, converts into imines, which on hydrolysis can give aldehyde, and that reaction is known as Stefan reaction. Okay, now even selectively we can also reduce this nitriles and esters into corresponding aldehydes. That selective reducing agent is Dibol-H, that is diisobutyl aluminium hydride. When you take this selectively at certain position only, the reduction will take place and can give aldehyde. For example, RCN nitrile I am taking. When it undergo reduction in presence of aluminium hydride tertiary butyl, okay, followed by hydrolysis, it can be converted into RCHO, that is aldehyde. Okay, next, that is one of the example for this from nitriles and esters. So even esters, so esters I am taking here CH3 CH2 C double bond O C2H5 ester. Now this ester undergo reduction in presence of Dibol-H. This is the structure of Dibol-H followed by hydrolysis. So exactly here bond involves in breakage. Here one hydrogen is added and here one hydrogen is added. Then we will get what? CH3 CH2 C double bond OH. That is aldehyde. Okay. Plus C2H5OH. Alcohol. That's it. So this is our primer product. So aldehyde is obtained. And this reaction is known as Stefan reaction. Even it is important for 2 marks. So in the Stefan reaction, nitriles undergo reduction in presence of HCl and stannous chloride, converts into imines, which on hydrolysis converts into aldehyde. Even the same reduction can be done selectively by Dibol-H, that is diisobutyl aluminium hydride. So even here, nitriles and esters undergo reduction by this Dibol-H, converts into corresponding aldehydes. Now, the third preparation method is from hydrocarbons. Hydrocarbons are the compounds which are containing only hydrogen and carbons. Okay, there are several methods. If you want to prepare aromatic aldehyde, take aromatic hydrocarbon. Aliphatic compound means we have to take aliphatic hydrocarbon. So here, there are 3 different methods under this. First one is by oxidation of methyl benzene. Methyl benzene is nothing but toluene. When this toluene undergo oxidation in presence of strong oxidizing agent, it can be directly converted into benzoic acid. Okay, if you want to stop this reaction of formation of benzoic acid, so then it can be formed benzaldehyde by the oxidation reaction. If you use a selective oxidizing agent, it can stop with the formation of intermediate. If intermediate is formed, that intermediate cannot be converted into benzoic acid. Only it stops with benzaldehyde. So toluene can also be converted into benzaldehyde. If we use selective oxidizing agent, it can form intermediate. By this intermediate, we can expect only benzaldehyde but not benzoic acid. So under this, the first one is oxidizing agent. What we are using here is chromyl chloride. So chromyl chloride formula CrO2Cl2. Very, very, very important for 1 mark question. So what is chromyl chloride? That is CrO2Cl2. Or what is the oxidizing agent used in Etaud reaction? That is chromyl chloride. Very important for 1 mark. Note it down. CrO2Cl2 is the oxidizing agent used in Etaud reaction. In this ETARD reaction, methyl benzene, that is nothing but toluene, undergo oxidation in presence of chromyl chloride. First converts into intermediate, that is, this is intermediate. That is chromium complex. When this chromium complex undergo hydrolysis, it can give benzaldehyde. Listen carefully. When methyl benzene undergo oxidation in presence of chromyl chloride, first converts into a chromium complex, which is an intermediate. Upon hydrolysis, it can be converted into benzaldehyde. We'll see the reaction. See, first take methyl benzene. A methyl group which is located on benzene ring is known as methyl benzene. When it undergo reaction with chromyl chloride, CrO2Cl2 in presence of carbon bisulfide. Okay, it can be converted into an intermediate, that is chromium complex. Here CrOH Cl2 taken twice will be obtained. This is called chromium complex. Okay, again this on hydrolysis, acid hydrolysis. Okay, exactly your bond involves a breakage. Oxygen of water is added to CH, converts into CHO, that is benzaldehyde. Okay, here you may get a doubt why and how this complex is obtained. Okay, we'll see that now. And see here, this is methyl benzene. I have written like this for our convenience. I have separated these three hydrogen atoms. Okay, CrO2Cl2, I have written like this, CrO2Cl2. Okay, now among chromium and oxygen, which is more electronegative? Oxygen. So it tries to take these pi bonded electrons towards oxygen. Then oxygen gets negative charge. Immediately from this methyl benzene, one of the hydrogen eliminates and added to oxygen. Okay, from here completely this hydrogen broken and eliminated, added to this oxygen atom. Okay, converts to CrCl2OOH. CrOOHCl2 compound is obtained. Like that, when one more chromium chloride is added, again pi bond moves to oxygen. Oxygen gets negative charge. From this carbon, this hydrogen is added to oxygen, converts into OCrOHCl2. OCrOHCl2. Okay, now this chromium is lack of one bond and this chromium is lack of one bond. Now these two are added to CH. Now what is left here? CH group. That is what I have written. Benzene CH. OCrOHCl2 of two groups, that is by taken twice. Okay, in this manner we will get here chromium complex. When this chromium complex involves in acid hydrolysis, it can be converted into benzaldehyde. And this complete reaction is known as ETARD reaction. In this ETARD reaction, we can prepare benzaldehyde when aromatic substituted benzene reacts with chromyl chloride. Okay, what is the oxidizing agent used in this ETARD reaction? Chromyl chloride. And intermediate formed here is chromium complex. And next oxidation is use of chromium oxide. In last reaction, ETARD reaction, we have taken chromyl chloride. Here I am taking chromium oxide. So when toluene or substituted toluene is undergoing oxidation in presence of chromium oxide or chromic oxide, first it converts into benzylidine diacetate. So benzylidine diacetate, when again on hydrolysis, it converts into benzaldehyde. I am taking your toluene first. When this toluene reacts with chromium oxide or chromic oxide along with acetic anhydride CH3CO taken twice O, okay, at certain temperature 273 to 278 kelvins, first it converts into an intermediate of benzylidine diacetate CHO CO CH3 taken twice. Okay, this acetate group is added, then converts into benzylidine acetate, which again on hydrolysis, on heating, it can be converted into benzaldehyde. How we got here? Exactly bond broken here, oxygen of water added, converts into benzaldehyde. Understand? And next, another oxidation is by side chain chlorine. Sir, another method to form this aldehyde is by side chain chlorination followed by hydrolysis. Okay. In this case, first toluene undergo chlorination in presence of sunlight converts into benzyl chloride. This again on hydrolysis converts into benzaldehyde. I am taking here toluene. When it undergo chlorination in presence of sunlight, okay, two chlorines are there. If you take 2 moles of chlorines, totally 4 chlorides are present. In that 2 chlorides reacts with 2 hydrogens, eliminates as 2HCl. 1 hydrogen and 2 HCl, so 2Cl are present. That 1 hydrogen I am represent here, and 2 chlorine atoms are added, converts into benzyl chloride. When this benzyl chloride on hydrolysis at 373 Kelvin's temperature. Okay, so 2 chlorine atoms are replaced by oxygen, converts into CHO, that is benzaldehyde. That means when toluene or other substituted benzene undergo chlorination, converts into benzyl chloride, which on hydrolysis converts into aldehyde, benzaldehyde. Now see, the last and most important preparation method of aldehyde is Guttermann-Cotes reaction. This is also again important for 2 marks. So in this Guttermann-Cotes reaction, benzene undergo reaction with carbon monoxide and halogen acid in presence of anhydrous AlCl3 or copper chloride converts into benzaldehyde. So first take benzene. When this benzene reacts with carbon monoxide and HCl, okay, in presence of AlCl3. So this carbon monoxide and hydrogen together react, okay, converts into CHO. From here hydrogen eliminated and reacts with Cl can give HCl, and finally we will get here benzaldehyde, that is CHO. Okay, benzaldehyde is obtained, CHO is added here and we got benzaldehyde, and this method is known as Guttermann-Cotes reaction. Okay, this is very, very, very important either for 1 mark or for 2 marks. In Guttermann-Cotes reaction, benzene reacts with carbon monoxide and HCl in presence of AlCl3, converts into benzaldehyde. Okay, are you clear? I think you are clear about this preparations. So initially we have seen about the common methods to prepare these aldehydes and ketones. And later we have seen the only methods to prepare aldehydes. Under that we have studied many. All these are very important for preparation of aldehydes in the laboratory. So in next class, we will discuss about the preparations of ketones. Thank you.